If you're interested in competitive at all or even popular controller players, you've probably heard the name Unknown X Army. Unknown is one of the most popular controller players due to his amazing movement, his monster aim, and his flawless W key ability. Unknown is so darn good. I just said the word darn again, I love that word. With his aggressive playstyle that, all right, get this, he's gotten first place in Cash Cups without getting a single win. And he's gotten top 5 in a Cash Cup on mouse and keyboard. Yo, that's crazy. I wish I was that good one day. But before we start the video, if you guys are looking to get better at Fortnite, click the link below to go to ProGuys.com, where you can play with the best players in the world. Sign up for our membership at ProGuys, and you're gonna get a ton of incredible content from the best pro players like Benji and Mongrel, and more World Cup champions are even coming soon. If you wanna compete in Fortnite, you gotta check out ProGuys.com. Finally, before we get into it, all right, let's do the question of the day. Who's ready for that? All right, today's question is, do you prefer to watch mouse and keyboard or controller gameplay? Personally, you know, I think both of them are really good, and I'm completely 50-50 on this, but let me know in the comments what you guys think about this, all right? I'm looking forward to reading what you have to say. In this analysis, we're actually going to be watching one of Unknown's games on mouse and keyboard. However, you know, almost everything we talk about is going to be relevant to all platforms, so be sure to stick around for the whole thing, guys. What's going on, guys? It is your motivation guy. I hope you pumped up. It's your friend, the one and only. Come on, say it with me, Keith Allen. I want to inspire you guys to be great, not only in this game, but also in life, man. I'm touched by all the DMs I've been getting on my Insta about how these motivational, you know, intros have been helping you guys out. That's what I want to do. I want to inspire you guys to be great because there's greatness on the inside of you. Make sure to connect with me at my new Instagram, which is Your Motivation Guy. Once again, at Your Motivation Guy is going down. It's time to sit back, relax, come on now, and get my favorite candy. Say it with me. It's that Bunch of Crunch, and let's get this going. So we can see right at the start that Unknown lands at Slurpee Swamp. Slurpee is one of the most aggressive spots and is great for skilled players who want kills off spawn. The reason for this is that Slurpee has 13 chests in the main area and 32 around the swamp as a whole, along with slurp trucks and a ton of slurp barrels to minimize shield RNG. With great loot and maximum shield off spawn, Slurpee is the best aggressive, you know, low RNG spot. And it makes sense that an insane aggressive player like Unknown would land there in Cash Cups. Unknown decides to land at the far side of Slurpee. This side has less loot, but, you know, in turn, it is less populated. We've noticed that Unknown doesn't typically fight instantly off spawn unless he has a really good weapon and high ground. In this case, there was an opponent right on the other building, who presumably had zero materials because he just landed. And on top of all of this, wasn't even looking in Unknown's direction. All right, that's a free kill if I've ever seen one. Get it. Unknown heads down into his building to max out his shield and loot up a bit more before he starts fighting. Since he's in Slurpee, it's pretty easy for him to just max out his shield and get decent loot. With max shield and solid loot, whew, Unknown is ready to punish whoever's in his way. He sees out of the corner of his eye the elimination animation. Wow, that kind of rhymed, but whatever. He can make a few assumptions from this one, all right? First, the winning player is likely low on shield from the early game fight and was using a pistol, so his loot likely isn't that great, even if he did have a shield. Unknown does his signature crouch walk to sneak up on his opponent and gets a clean laser before he can even react. Two kills so far, whew, not a tick of damage taken. Oh man, looking good. With nobody in his vicinity, man, Unknown takes his opportunity to grab more materials and prepare for his rotation. Super smart. Since this is an earlier game, it's pretty easy to push out and go for fights. However, if this was like a later game, it'd be best to just lurk around Slurpee and just look for more loot because the players are usually better. Unknown is running around Slurpee when he notices an enemy on the rooftop. He immediately starts building up for high ground. High ground is even more crucial nowadays with SMGs that can shoot through builds. Whoever is on the high ground, my friends, has a control of the fight. And we're gonna see that throughout this video, how important high ground actually is for him, especially when he plays aggressive. Unknown makes a beautiful play right here. Check this out. He cones his opponent and he builds up a bit, but doesn't actually go up. This makes his opponent think he's up top, but while his opponent is looking up for a shot, Unknown edits on him from below and scores a nice tag with his pump. Unknown's usage of angles and trick plays really gives him an edge in his fights. After this, knowing his opponent is already low, Unknown gives him no chance to get away and heal. You know, I like to take note of his piece control right here. Unknown immediately jumps up and he places a cone above his opponent to avoid him, building for height and a wall in front so he can't be blocked off. Peace Control, guys, it's a really underrated trick Unknown always uses, you know? His Peace Control right here is the reason he's able to simply edit and score a free kill without his opponent being able to do anything about it. All right, I like to go a bit more in depth on Peace Control right here, all right? Because this is a concept any advanced player needs to know. Peace Control refers to your control of build pieces in your fights. You got it? Obviously, you know, if like a piece is yours, your opponent can't edit it, build onto it, or break it without a few seconds of time. This is why, guys, taking pieces during your fights is so important. The more pieces you have, the more control you have over what your opponent can do. You know, we can see how Unknown's wall and cone ensure his opponent has basically no escape route, and in turn, gets him an easy kill. Next time you're in a fight, all right, try utilizing as many build pieces as possible, just like Unknown does in this insane clip. So Unknown sees a wood wall being built and decides to push. This is a safe play because they're on the far edge of the map and nobody should be around a third party. Unknown pushes up for height and his opponent makes the fatal mistake of boxing up below him. Unknown applies pressure using grenades and then goes for his opponent's wall. He gets it on the first try and hits a beautiful shot, followed up by some burst AR shots on his white health. Unknown knows his opponent is around or below 60 HP. He continues to apply as much pressure as possible, but his kill unfortunately gets stolen. Unknown played this fight very well. The ending was just really unfortunate. He starts taking a bit of spray from the kill stealer, takes a heavy laser, and pushes back to heal up and reset the fight. Luckily, due to his drop in Slurpee Swamp, he has a ton of slurp fish and minis he can use to get back up on shield. Unknown makes a play for height, right? By spraying his opponent down and gets a brutal laser on him. We can't even say aim assist either, because he's on mouse and keyboard. Wow. He cracks his opponent's shield and pushes for height, knowing he's under 100 HP. Unknown pulls off another insane Peace Control play by coning his opponent and walling in between them to avoid any counter builds, and finishes the fight with a few clean shots. This fight went from a brutal kill steal and 150 HP laser to a beautiful looking kill for some insane loot. When the next zone is popped up, Unknown starts running immediately. All right, so when you're playing aggressive, the storm is gonna be your worst enemy, so always try to rotate early and get ahead, all right? You know, that way, if a fight ever goes on long, you're still gonna be safe in zone, as opposed to like being stuck in the storm and likely dying because of it. So, after making it into the zone safely due to his early rotation, bravo, Unknown finds an unsuspecting player. He lines up his shot and he hits the opponent for 66. All right, so watch how much pressure he applies while he pushes, so his opponent can't even heal up. He cracks the opponent, but also gets hit pretty hard as well. He decides to heal up, pushes back up, and hits his opponent heavily again. However, the other player decides to push him. All right, so what are you gonna do? Unknown pushes for height, and he hears the opponent get sniped. Knowing he's below 100 HP, he pushes straight in for an easy kill. Immediately after this, without even any hesitation, Unknown looks for the opponent he hit to white health. He spots the player rotating on low ground and takes some shots, unfortunately not hitting him. Unknown knows the player is low and he pushes in for the relatively easy kill. All right, so at this point, you know, we understand Unknown's early to mid-game strategy, right? Simply jump on every vulnerable player, utilize as many build pieces as possible, stay on high ground, and apply constant pressure. Almost any opponent crumbles under his plan. All right, let's watch his endgame. He's at 10 kills right here, right? And has a great loot due to his killing spree. Unknown creates a huge tunnel with the extra materials from his last kill and still has almost full materials. He spots a player rotating in and he tries to get some shots, but unfortunately doesn't hit him. The zone pops up and he doesn't even take a second to think. He just immediately rotates on foot. Oh my goodness, man. Rotating early is so crucial in cash cups, as you know, any late rotators are gonna end up getting focused on by the entire lobby. Unknown knows better than this, so he goes straight in, only using a few builds to cover his back on his way there. After reaching safety, he decides to put a bit of pressure on an opponent spraying him, and somehow, someway, lasers him to white health. Even though it's a later zone with people around, Unknown knows this kill is too free to pass up, and it's gonna give him better position moving forward. He grabs the opponent's wall, and he does a textbook edit play to finish the job without taking any damage. He also hears an opponent down low around his old tunnel and decides to push in, knowing his opponent is on poor position and is likely in shambles due to his decision to rotate later. However, you know, he decides that the opponent is likely a good player because he reacted so fast. This was the best play anyways, as he would have been giving up his good position for just one potential point. Now that Anon is back up on his base, let's take a look at why you shouldn't rotate late. Alright, so check this out. Take a look at these players fighting on edge zone. These were the same players who were next to Anon before he made his rotation, and now they're both getting focused and basically lost the game already. From his safe mid zone position, Anon searches for tags, but unfortunately doesn't quite get any kills until he sees one last opponent pushing in, who he picks up with one white tag. Every single player who rotated late got focused on by the entire lobby, and what happened? They died. That's why you don't rotate late in cash cups, guys. Anon makes yet another early rotation, this time to the 6th zone. He spots a vulnerable opponent and he takes him by surprise, getting a pretty easy textbook kill right here. However, he also gets hit to 34 HP by the player behind him. Uh-oh. Instead of panicking, which mostly all of us would do, he builds with his strong materials to disengage and quickly gets back up to almost maximum shield. This is why Slurpfish are so amazing. He's now on full health, almost full shield, and has a short rotation to the next zone. He realizes high ground is free, and since he's nearly in zone and has decent materials, he pushes up and he gets it with ease and begins putting pressure on the rest of the lobby. He continues to laser players from his high ground position, gets a clean trap kill on a player pushing for height, and he turns it into a 1v1. With his amazing piece control, he places a floor and a cone right where he expects his opponent to jump, and he hits a beautiful 120 damage pump shot to end off this 16 kill game, man. Wow. Alright, so let's recap what we learned from Anon in this analysis. Alright, first things first, pushing for high ground and keeping consistent pressure on your opponents during fights is absolutely crucial. Did you hear what I said? Absolutely crucial. Effective piece control is also extremely overpowered, and practicing your prediction and awareness to improve piece control will absolutely pay dividends. Getting an early laser and applying consistent pressure is also hugely important during any fight, especially if your opponent starts on 200 HP. You're gonna be shocked at how much of a difference 60 AR damage can really make in a fight, especially if your pressure is good enough to avoid any healing. In late game, you know, Anon pushes for high ground around the 6th zone, and he holds it until the final 1v1. Searching for tags on low ground players, man, is great. Finally, arguably the most important thing is to play with confidence. Everybody say confidence. Thank you. You know, one of the main reasons Anon is so dominant is because he believes in himself. You have to believe in yourself, guys. You really, really do. I don't care if nobody else believes in you. You gotta believe in yourself, period. Know that you're a great player, and above all else, man, this is what you need in order to be great at this game. All right, guys, once again, this is your motivation guide. That's right, your friend. Come on, stay with me, the one and only Keith Allen. Hope you enjoyed this video, man. Connect with me as soon as you can on my new Insta at Your Motivation Guy. You're the best. Know that. You're great. Know that. Don't surrender. Don't quit, because quitters, man, we always regret. We always regret when we quit. So don't do it. Stick with it to the end. All right, guys, that's going to be all for today's video. Go into your next early game confident, man, knowing that you've got a good strategy and can come out of your fights with good loot, materials, and a good path to the end game. You know, we really hope you enjoyed this. Don't forget to use code PROGUIDES in the Fortnite item shop when you make any sort of purchases. It just really helps us out, and we really do appreciate it. Comment down below what you thought about this video and what you'd like to see next on the channel. We aim to bring you guys the best daily Fortnite content, so do us a favor by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and showing ProGuides.com some love for bringing you this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.